How I install mods in 7 Days to Die. There are two things to note in this video. I will leave timestamps down below if you wanted to jump around. One, move save data folder out of appdata, because all mods are now going to be required to be installed into the appdata folder. Two, installing said mods into the folder that you have now moved. So the first thing that you want to do, go into where you have 7 Days to Die installed. If you do not know where that is, you can open Steam, right click on your 7 Days to Die and go to manage, then go to browse local files. Go back one so that you see the list of games installed. You're going to right click and copy, then right click in a blank space here, right click again, paste, and you're going to make one copy of the game. And the reason why you're going to make one copy of the game, you only need one, is so that if the Fun Pimps update your main copy, which would be up here, then you can continue having one copy to work off of that's modded, that's not going to affect your games, even if they send out an update and break all the mods again, which they did in August of 2022. So if you were going and looking for mods, you need to make sure that it is for the version that you have installed. Now that it's done copying, I'm going to rename this. Well, I'll put 21 copy. You're going to need to go to your app data and move your save games out of your app data. What you'll do in your file explorer here, you will highlight here and then do %appdata%. So here is the app data. You're going to go into 7 Days to Die here. And here is all of your save files. Okay, so now what we're going to do, we're going to open another File Explorer window. So go down here, right click, and click on File Explorer. And now I am going to go to wherever I want to put my save games. In this case, it's D. So you'll see I have made the 7DTDGD, which stands for 7 Days to Die Game Data. You can name it whatever you want. So in here, I have already have my vanilla game. I moved it sometime last year. What I'm going to do is I'm going to create a new folder and I'm going to name it modded. So this will be one modded game that I want. You're going to go into your app data and you want your launcher settings and your user options so that you keep your settings that you had set, and you're going to drag and drop. You'll notice it says move. I don't want move. I want copy. So if it says move, we're going to hold down control until it says copy and then drop it. Now, the next thing that I'm going to want is I'm going to want a folder named saves. So right click new folder and put in saves. Capitalization is important. Make sure it's exactly like this. Go into that folder. And now you're going to want your profiles and your server admin.xml file. Your server admin is if you ever do any co-op hosting where you host and a friend connects to your computer to play, the server admin file is needed. If you don't, then you don't have to worry about it. But you can just drag and drop those over. Again, hold control to copy. So now we are good to go. We don't need any of the saves that are in here, like Navisgain, the Preachin 6K. Those will all be recreated. Back to our modded folder here. This is where the mods folder is going to be. So right click new folder and we're going to name it mods, again capital M, and now we're going to install mods into this folder. I have already downloaded a couple of mods. Make sure it's an alpha 21 mod. In this case, I have downloaded a mod that's alpha 21, no dew heat. The dew collector will not produce heat. Just double click on it. It'll open it in Windows. Let's go into this folder. You want to make sure that you find the mod info.xml. That's the beginning of the mod. And then you're going to go up one. So this is the folder that we need. Sometimes there are multiple folders. And if that's the case, then you just need to find where that mod.xml is. If you are downloading an overhaul, they may have multiple folders within there. So they may have multiple mods packaged within the same overhaul. In that case, you kind of want to follow their instructions because it can be a little bit different. This one has the mod info.xml. It's just a config change. It just has a config file. So that's all that we need is this folder. We're going to drag and drop this in. You'll notice it says copy. And now we have installed mods. Nice. Let's say you want a different game. You want a different set of mods. Just do new folder, and then we'll do modded one. And in the downloads, I have another one of rain collector, which turns the dew collector into a rain collector. And here is an example of what I said about having multiple folders. So this one has this folder, which is a .zip folder, and then you go into it, there's another folder. And then under that one is where all of the info is, the mod XML and everything. We're going to go ahead and take these out. We'll just highlight, hold shift, and then click the last one. And that will allow us to highlight everything. Right click, copy. And then we're going to go back up. We're going to go into modded one and then right click, paste. Because that's all that we need, right? So then again, we're going to put in our mods folder. And you'll notice I didn't copy the mods from the other one. And that's simply because I don't want that other mod. So I want a blank folder. And now I'm going to drag and drop from the zip file. Okay, so now I have a modded one with this mod. And then I have this one, which is just regular modded into mods. And then this one. And that's it, right? Well, not quite. We need to tell it to load the game from our 21 copy and where the save file is. So what you want to do is you want to go up here to games, go to add a non-Steam game. I am sorry about my dog barking his full head off in the background. Go to browse. You're going to have to find where your game is located. So here's where my copy is. You'll need to go wherever yours is. In here, you can select SD Launcher if you're ever going to need to use EAC. If you are never going to be on a public server, then you can select this one. I'll just do SD Launcher. Click open, add selected program. There we go. So now you're going to right click, go to properties, and then rename this to what you want. In this case, I'm going to name it to seven Days to Die 21 Modded. Let's do it again. So we'll go to games, add a non-Steam game, browse. Again, we want the 7 Days to Die 21 copy. We don't need to copy it again. Do 7D launcher and then add selected program. And then we will rename this to 7 Days to Die 21 modded one to correspond with this folder here. So now we have one copy of the game running several different save profiles. So now we've got dash user data folder. And so now it will save all of our saved game files for this one to modded. So now we have user data folder for modded one. That will set this game to load from over here. If we load this one, actually, let me go ahead and switch this over so you don't have to hear it. You're going to hear it anyways for a second. There we go. So now when you go into continue game, you will see that there's nothing here because it's not finding anything because you moved your save files. All right. So now when you create a new game, you'll see you have the different options just as you regularly would for your Alpha 21. And it will be modded as for the mods that you had installed. I hope this helped you to install mods into your 7 Days to Die game as you would previously, but now with only one copy of the game, and so you can save your drive space. Enjoy your summer and happy gaming.